So we continue with the next talk. Our next speaker is Thomas Otto, and he's talking about the backup report of the Friedrich Schiller University in Jena.
Thank you for the introduction. Yes, of course, we are a big university migrated our backup to Barrios, and how it works, I would show you. On the first, it's the overview. There are many faculties, a 10 number, and there are different requirements. Some need not only computers, some especially power users on computers, and other facilities and departments. It's very heterogeneous. I would show you with this side. So in the university, there's a freedom of research and education, and also there are some departments or institutions that are rival to each other, and there has to be a separation that only see his own information, especially with the restricted consoles, and it want to restore that they not see with other institutions have data in this. We had two backup systems. One was the VeritasNet backup. It was our old backup system, and there's of course no support for now. And we had to try, or we tried to replace this with the Time Navigator, but this backup solution is not satisfactory for us. And there some years we tried it, but after the license expired in a year, we want to show or we evaluate other backup solutions. It's also we want a backup solution that it's not to replace every year. It's a thing you want to have a long term and satisfying with this. In detail, then the net backup has an antique GUI. It has, of course, a command line interface, and it's also good that it saves its data like tar format, and we can save this in our HSM system, who migrate automatically into tapes. But the problems are that the high costs of license. Also that the client partly difficult to install, and it's not intuitively to restore on the client. Also it's not works on all clients without admin. So the Time Navigator has other problems. The campus license, which includes all features, there are many features that works. It's not too expensive. It's also an intuitive restore on the client. You can start a GUI and restore our files. The problem is you can restore files from a different client. It's not possible without admin rights, with catalog admin rights. Also, there are some restrictions. As an expert, you can see all backups there in the system. Once you installed a client, you can from there see what other backups are configured completely. And also, there possible to restore some readable files from other clients. Also a big problem is there was a limited catalog, no SQL, and this limit we also reached. After this, it don't work. This is a no-go, I think. Yes, there are not really direct spooling possible, and we have to save the backups to VTL, and then migrate it to tapes. So we evaluate our needs we want to have. A backup system have to be stable in configuration, the system itself, the catalog, test some rights management. We would not manage all clients, or we can't manage all clients, and we also are not the power, the manpower to this. And we want some admins on some institutions to can handle this, and then they have to some rights, but not all rights. Yes, that one part, we have a problem with some desktops and laptops. It's not nice to handle this, that we have to handle this, but some clients are there, and they are not every time online, not regularly. If you say we have a full backup every Wednesday night, they have to put or leave on his computer online, but this works not every time. And so they have, we have to handle this in a way, or the new backup system have to handle this. Of course, we have some zoo of clients, the normal and other special things. Very heterogeneous. This is not only in our IT department, also in faculties possible. They have their own filer or something. Then we evaluate Pareos. I think the positives are that open source, and we don't have ever migrate if we don't want it. It's a big positive, I think. Also that it's use a real SQL database. There are no restrictions. Also you can show in the SQL database and look like own reports or what is saved. And use a standard, and you can implement some self-service for a user with restricted consoles or notifications after backup is running. Yes, then the commander interface is very likely and scriptable. But this later, I think. Yes, the cons there is not a really usable GUI. The command line interface is very good, but the GUI, the bad was, is not really usable for users. The web GUI was on this time not ready, and especially not for some LDAP users, LDAP users. Of course, we have a big file service, an Isilon cluster. This has to back up with NDMP at file level. This was also not ready. There was the option to develop this. Some other special clients not already finished. We look like this and think, for SQL databases, we can use a run before script and dump this with SQL normal. Yes. And Exchange is really, also it's like the same way we run a backup with internal mechanism and then save this dump or images with Barrios. For NDMP, we use founded development. It was a little difficult to argue this. But money, it costs some for open source, it's a little problem. But we used the last year of support of our Time Navigator and says it's not necessary to have this support if there was work, the NDMP on Barrios. And so it's possible that he can get this, take this money for this. As for GUI, the web GUI is hopefully coming soon, but also we want some single lock-on for the user, not new management for user, no a new user ID, new password for a backup. We want that they use the normal logins they already have for other things, for VMware. It's we can use the temporary VMware integrated backup. Yes. The plan was now to use consulting for initial installing and then get the knowledge to run by our own. We have to replace our backup systems until this year because of the license of the Time Navigator and also use the existing library. This was the start. We have our NetBackup system runs on Solaris. We stores his data on a HSM system and move automatically or migrated automatically to the tapes. Also, we have our Time Navigator server, which handles the library directly. And now we want a new backup system with a new server, we byte and handle also data. Now, no money for a new library. How handle this? We want to make the first is we have to migrate the clients from Time Navigator to the Barrios. And then at the end, we want to use the library to store the data. And we used consulting for initial installing. Our consultant was Daniel Neuberger. Thanks for this thing. It's good work to done, I think. There's some normal things we when you install a new backup system. The goal was to save the data on the HSM system temporarily, and so we have the Solaris storage daemon on this. After a lot of migration is done, this was space on our library, and we can split it in a new partition for Barrios and can more and more use the also not only the HSM system, but directly the library with spooling. Yes, I found it was very easy to increase the tape slots and barriers. It's nearly online possible. Time to time, more and more backup clients migrate. Then we can use the whole partition for this for barriers. And Time Navigator was shut down this year in May. Then we used the Solaris storage daemon only for desktops and laptops because of the virtual foils I show you later. And the normal server backups and big backups are served to the library directly. For server backups, we backup our data to spool and they spool to the library. And we have some pools and also some special pools. We found there was a problem with the tape drive reservation. First, we have two drives in the partition, and there is the problem that only that two pools with running blocks the tape drive the whole time after the last backup of this pool is finished, then can start backups with the next pool. And so it's possible one pool with very slow, possible only spooling not a whole day, but the tape drive is blocked. Now we have four drives. The problem is other. We have a pool. There's all backups of one pool only uses one drive. And if in our implementation, many backups, there are a few pools, and only two drives efficient works, and the other is suspended. For desktop backup, we have another solution. We trigger a job 3 times a day, and if this job checks or it selects all clients who are desktops and checks tests of their online and have the barrier storage daemon is open, and then starts the incremental backup. So and from time to time, two times per month, we start a virtual full backup of these jobs. This we done with the Solaris storage daemon with a virtual auto changer, because there we can implement 10 or drives parallel. Yes, our summary, I think it works like designed. It's very stable. Running database configuration, also good, I think. It's a likely command interface, also for scripting and pipe, useful for some. Also, we use some own SQL reports. We have the founded development for the NMP. This was a good solution, and with our current status of over 1 billion files and like a petabyte of data saved nearly on tapes. Uh, now some specials we implement for in our environment. The first is we want to implement a self-service. The first is to notify the user of is failed or backup. There is implement this with a status script that runs after the job, and the script looks at the configuration. Then we use the description field of the client in a well-known format. There is the email address, also like the mode. For some, the normal is that only warnings or errors are reported to the user, that there are not too much mails. The ignores the errors that after too much okays, but also it's possible to get all mails. Yes, the script collects the data and format it. Then email to this. The next is we use restricted consoles for some admins or users. The solution is we have one single file for each client configuration, and in this file there a comment which ignores by barriers, but we pass this for the in the script. Who should admin for this client, and then the script automatically generates the necessary RCLs for jobs, clients, file sets, and so on. Also, to get an LDAP login possibility, we have a remote host where LDAP login is enabled. The script handled this also, and for the admins, they were enabled on this host and copied a bconsole configuration with the random password. So the user have only login to this remote host and can dot there start his bconsole and not need another password for BIOS. Also, we implement a status monitor. It's only a status storage with a AVK script to format it in a better way. I think it's not really readable, but I can't shrink it in other way. You can see it's much jobs start running. The actual jobs are running, what level, how's the name, in which pool they are stored, and also which files and data also already transmitted, and how is the throughput now, and also the spooling directory. It's nice if the backups runs, you can see how is the throughput and where's the main problem or work there. Also, you can see it's spooling or day spool or the waiting for day spooling. It's all the information which status storage you give in the other format. The next is a SQL report for expired volumes. Here I can see or watch for it's necessary to get more scratch tapes, or it is possible for this pool to get for the next backup. The BIOS can take already a tape which is in the pool, but it's expired now. Here is like the expire time, and also if the jobs not finished. Some pictures, script integration in Agios and PNP, how the pool is growing, or how the sketch pool is shrinking. There are some peaks because we add more sketch shapes because of this, it looks like this. Also the performance. I look for this talk. I was surprised for this, but not because of Bareos is so performance, but our infrastructure now. I think this was on the beginning, not in this part. We can save or handle 10 gigabits with our storage daemon or with our Bareos server. But also this saved our this is the network interface, and this is the spooling device. It's were saved, but the spooling space is not enough, and also the migration to tapes, it's not the well throughput. There we have to look like this on this. Yes, there are a list of wishes for the future, some also reported, but not all. Of course, the efficient use of tape drives that we can use our four drives in an efficient way. So the idea, I know that's not easy, but it's for the future, I think. I think something like reserve on demand or not on spooling, when the job is spooling some hours, the other job can also finish with this spooling. It's and also not only for one pool, I think it's or more drives for one pool. It should possible. The list command respect ACL REST is also fixed in the new version. I think it's very necessary to use the PAM interface for it, that we can use LDAP users. The web UI I sometimes show or sometimes look at this seems to be useful, but to use for our customers, we want a single log-on possibility. Yes, other is we use spooling for all jobs. And some jobs are very long running. And it's eventually possible to parallel despool and spooling for a job. Yes, another institution give us the introduction that on their backup system was the possibility to audit a volume. It sounds good. I think it audited volume, and then the Bareos have to look if there is the data on the volume would it expect. And the last point is auto update for Windows clients, but I not really an idea of this good idea and in which way this. It also, I only found that we are on Windows some 14.2 clients, and on Linux we have a repository auto update in this way, but not for Windows. Yes. Was about very fast, but we have by lunch some questions.
One moment, please. I come with the microphone. It's better for the recording.
But you still also use your NETs backup system, or is this?
Yes, of course, we have to use our net backup system. We want to migrate it also to Barrios. But now we have the problem also that is the time to do this. But the library not enough storage to handle the data. We have to migrate the clients. It's a plan, not hopefully next year, but this year it's difficult to get the money for extension for the library.
But all features that you require are in Barrios. So there are no net backup features that are missing in Barrios.
Yes, of course. For this, we don't need something.
Any more questions this time? Okay.
How long was the time it took to migrate from to Barrios?
Only the time, I think. This was from beginning this year. After the May, we shut down the Time Navigator server. Yes, the problem on this was to contact the clients, and there and possibly not more there and something, and you have to make a hard cut and say, if you don't migrate, you have lost your backup data. Yeah, we contact these users several times, and if it's not possible, one time you have to shut down.
Did you publish your different script somewhere online?
Open source? What for script?
I think there is contact users and perhaps
not at this time, but if someone wants it, I can do this.
I think
it's no problem.
I think it could be a good idea somewhere inside Wiki, yeah, or contribution, yeah.
Yes, I can talk with Barrios.
Would be nice to show other people that perhaps are looking for kind of same solution to just share the work and say, hey.
It would be no problem. This.
Okay, no more, then I think we're done. Thank you very much.